I got a really good question from a lot of people. Is it worth it to come to Disneyland right now? Is it worth it to come during the pandemic when a lot of things aren't open, lines are super long, everything is mobile ordering? And let's try to answer that question today. Is it worth it?
I'm not gonna lie, that doesn't make me feel any better right now.
This is the madness that is the first cast member preview. Look at all those people. Everyone totally staying 6 feet apart. Okay, so this is the line to get in, to go through security under the parking structure and then walk to the parks. So it's kind of a huge mess. As soon as people are getting off the escalator, they're immediately getting in a line, but it's a line that just merges into one. I don't know what's going on, but they're not really prepared. Okay, now we're back under the structure again, being sent away from security and hopefully coming back. This whole setup is a little Looney Tunes. And there's one cast member separating the back of the line from the front of the line. Okay, now we're heading into the Pixar Pals portion of the parking structure. All right, time to go down the walkway over to Disneyland. Look at this setup. I don't know what they were trying to do, but no one is keeping a safe distance. No one is trying to wait in line. Everyone's just kind of pushing their way through the gates to wait in line to go through security. The wait in line to get to security is terrible, but security is actually moving really, really fast. Ooh, they got little trash cans with hand sanitizer. They don't have a washing station. Those are super weird when they have those out. Oh, you can hear the boulder at Indiana Jones. Did you hear that?
That was the boulder.
That rumbling, yeah, that's the boulder. Because that's that big green building right there on the left, that's Indiana Jones. That's so weird. Finally back at Disneyland. I don't know why, but every line is taking forever to get in. So hopefully that ends as soon as we get on an attraction or in line for an attraction, because this is getting crazy. Here's a look at how long the lines are trying to get into Disneyland and into DCA. They're actually backing up into each other right over here. So this is really terrible for social distancing, and I don't know if they even have a plan to fix this. Finally in Disneyland. It's been forever. Main Street USA is hustling and bustling. They have the cars out, they have the horses out, they got the characters out, the railroad's coming in, the train's coming in, not the railroad doesn't move. This is so weird, but awesome. But weird, but it's weird, but it's awesome. But it's so cool.
That was so scary.
Donald! So it looks like for the Jolly Holiday, they're taking over this entire sidewalk area with outdoor seating. So there's even more seating now for you to enjoy your meal.
Go this way.
Okay, first things first, going over to the Falcon, because the group I'm with has never even seen Galaxy's Edge, so we're doing that first. I'm surprised they're actually running the Mark Twain right now. That's really cool. I think they're running it. Maybe it's just parked. Big Thunder Mountain Railroad's running and it's a 5-minute wait. The wait times right now are really low, but I'm guessing those wait times are gonna jump in about 2 hours because that's how long it takes to get through the main entrance right now. It's time for Galaxy's Edge West Coast. Time for Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run. Let's see if we can't totally destroy the Falcon today. Maybe we will. So right now for Falcon, they're actually having us go through what was supposed to be the fast pass line for this ride. The regular queue is still open, so it's not that busy yet. But there's still a decent amount of people. Let's go make Hondo money! We don't get to keep any of it. Wait, credits. It's not called money, right? It's good to be back inside the Falcon.
Today's flight takes you to the planet Morelia. You will be intercepting a first order trading shipment of coaxium. Gunners, you clear the path. Pilots, line up behind the train. And engineers, you are pulling that precious cargo. Pilot on the back.
They're gonna have a picture of us out front, not letting us in again. I'm like, oh, you guys? Yeah, no. You ran the Falcon into a planet. So mobile ordering is just going okay. They have a lot of seating. But it was only 7 minutes after I said I'm here for my check-in for my mobile order on the Disneyland app. Checked in like they're doing right there with the cast member. They send you to a window that corresponds with your number. Walk up, and I am next to grab my food. So I'm staying super basic, and I got chicken tendies and a Coke Zero. Because like Grogu, I enjoy the simple things in life. I really do. And this is my view for lunch. So for the cast member preview, Blue Bayou is totally closed. They are serving alcohol soon, and of course I'm sure Club 33 is closed as well. If these long lines and mass inefficiency are any signs of what's gonna happen when this park officially reopens, I would highly suggest not coming here until maybe after June 15th or a little bit later. As I'm sure no one was wondering, Pirate's Lair is closed for today. This is the cast preview though, so they might not be open at all till opening day, but for today it's not open. Splash Mountain, Splash Mountain. No. As soon as we got into the station, we loaded immediately. There was absolutely no wait. All right, it's finally time to head into the Haunted Mansion. Check out anything that's new. The queue for the Haunted Mansion is so much better like this. When this used to be fully open, you'd have people standing on top of each other. It was super claustrophobic, but now there's tons of space, nice sunlight. The line's actually moving really, really well.
Tour begins here in this gallery, where you see paintings of some of our guests as they appeared in their corruptible, mortal state.
Ladies and gentlemen, to best view the floor portraits my master so kindly hung himself, please refrain from leaning against the walls. As a reminder, face coverings are required at all times.
Your cadaverous pallor betrays an aura of foreboding. Almost as though you sense a disquieting metamorphosis. Is this haunted room actually stretching? Or is it your imagination? And consider this dismaying observation. This chamber has no windows and no doors. Which offers you this chilling challenge. To find a way out. Of course, there's always my way. Oh, I didn't mean to frighten you prematurely. The real chills come later. Now, as they say, look alive, and we'll continue our little tour. And let's all stay together.
Good? Okay, thank you. Walk slowly.
Oh, Find our new best friend.
And they'll haunt you until you return. Now I will raise the safety bar, and a ghost will follow you.
Finally time to be back on the Disneyland Railroad.
Oh, the Magic Kingdom Railroad's closed. This is the only running train on both coasts.
Here in Critter Country, you can join Winnie the Pooh, Tigger, Brer Rabbit, and Brer Bear on their fun-filled adventures.
I'm so sad. I can't go see my favorite bear.
As we steam past Hungry Bear Restaurant, past Outpost Amuse Parks, we're now joining up with the Rivers of America and entering the frontier as it looked more than a century and a half ago. This is my favorite part of the journey. Around every bend, there's natural beauty as far as the eye can see. There is the revered Indian shaman sharing his stories with those in the Great River Valley below.
I don't know if we're going
to
have time. There's not much of a line for It's a Small World. And the Matterhorn is closed.
As we leave Toontown Depot,
yeah, it's all boarded up.
Real nice view of the happiest land of the world.
There's nothing going on.
Fantasyland.
Yes, baby.
And there's no wait right now for Small World. Look at that.
Small World just below us. And, off in the distance, majestic Matterhorn Mountain.
It's his favorite.
Toontown, and Tomorrowland. We'll also visit the Grand Canyon and make a trip back in time to the primeval world and the age of the dinosaurs before returning to Main Street Station. As we begin our journey, remember that for a safe trip, you need to stay seated, keeping your hands, arms...
It's a beautiful day in Frontierland, and Big Thunder Mountain Railroad is only 5 minutes. 5 minutes. This is not going to happen again for a very long time. So far, Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run, Big Thunder Mountain Railroad, Splash Mountain, and the railroad, and even the mansion all had short waits.
Next up is Snow White's Enchanted Wish. They made a lot of changes, starting with the name. Inside the attraction, there are a few animatronics, projection mapping, and a few other things that they've changed. Let's go inside and check it out.
Ready.
Let's do this.
Thank you.
Snow White Enchanted Witch was amazing. I am astonished by how good they made this tiny little dark ride. I highly recommend everyone ride Snow White Enchanted Wish as soon as you get here. I may actually go back and get on this at the end of the night. We waited a total of 7 minutes to go on Peter Pan's flight. This is amazing. Fantasyland around 3:20 in the afternoon is dead. There's no line for Mr. Toad. We waited 7 minutes for Peter Pan. There's hardly any wait for Dumbo. Actually, I don't even see anybody in line for Dumbo. Wow, this is really cool. I thought at the beginning of the day, we were gonna have a terrible time. It took forever to get in the parking structure. It took forever to get in the park. But now things are starting to look up, and I'm really, really happy about that. So I may have changed my mind a few minutes ago about coming here early in April and in May.
Please remain seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs on the side, and do supervise your tour. Have a jolly good ride.
Unfortunately, Storybook Land is closed, so Monstro's not eating any boats today. But the teacups is open, woo! Another, hardly any wait for another Fantasyland ride. Oh, and Alice doesn't have much of a line either. Might have to go on that just because there's no line.
Oh,
time for Tomorrowland. First stop is Star Tours. I've been on Star Tours a couple times over at Disney's Hollywood Studios, but nothing compares to the Star Tours at Disneyland because I went there a million times as a kid. Ooh, that's right. They did this right before the closure. They have planters that were supposed to be fountains and a new design. That looks really good. I love this X-Wing. It used to be in the arcade, like Tomorrowland Arcade, next to the exit of Captain EO and Space Mountain. It used to be up in the rafters on the second floor, and it was there for a long time. It became part of the Space Mountain extended queue, and they put it in here. It's one of my favorite things because it's so big. It's not like the one in Galaxy's Edge, but it's still really cool. Ooh, they have Ahsoka Tano clone trooper. How much is this? $36.99. For me, it's totally worth it to come here the next few months. I know June 15th is when the governor has said that they're gonna reopen the whole state, but for me, coming here right now was amazing, and I still got 2.5 hours left. Well, that's a bummer. Space Mountain's closed. I don't know if it's gonna reopen or not, but it is closed right now. That really stinks. Is Pizza Planet open? No. Wait, maybe? No. I just got cinnamon sugar all over me.
You sure did.
I'm having problems.
Okay, so we're in Star Tours.
Mac and cheese. What do you say?
Over at the Galactic Grill, they actually have a fried chicken sandwich, and it's really, really good. I would give it a 8.2 out of 10. It's so slow, I'm even going on the Autopia because there was a 3-minute wait. Today is just ridiculous, and I love it. Here we go. Better not crash. I think I can officially say today was worth it. I love going on 12 different rides. I didn't get in until almost 10 o'clock, so the whole parking situation and the main entrance was really bad. I hope they fix that.
Everything in the park was perfect. We rarely waited more than 20 minutes for anything. So if the capacity is like this when they open, this is perfect. I love this. Stamp of approval, whatever else you need to hear.
Panchito's out. That is so cool. It's better that he's here than at the Three Caballeros ride over in Epcot.
Last ride of the night. This isn't just one of my favorite attractions ever. It's my family's favorite attraction ever. Amazing day. I'm really sad that the first hour or two that I was here on property over at the parking lot and in line to get into the parks was kind of a bummer. Like they don't have the best plan, I want to say, without being mean, for running that. They have time to practice, they have time to change stuff. I'm not really worried about it, but everything in the park was perfect. If this is the capacity they're going for the first like month and a half of reopening, it's gonna be perfect. We rarely waited over 20 minutes in line. We did 12 or 13 attractions, and we didn't get in until just after 10 o'clock. So we didn't even get here when the park opened, and we stayed till close. But yeah, it's totally worth it. If this is what it's gonna be like, it's worth it, but don't get frustrated with parking and with the main entrance. It's just taking some time to get through. They do need to open up more ticket booths. Hopefully they do that. But yeah, everything else was great. Train ride was great. Big Thunder Mountain Railroad was great. Most of the attractions that run pretty efficiently, like Big Thunder Mountain Railroad, Indiana Jones, and a few others, they ran great. Also, I highly recommend Snow White's Enchanted Wish to anyone that's been on Snow White's Scary Adventure before or has never been on either of those attractions. 10 out of 10. We went on it twice. I went on Splash Mountain twice. Thunder once. The list goes on. It was a good day. It was a very, very good day. It was just weird how frustrating parking, getting around the, whatever that mess was at the parking structure to go through security, because the security was fine, but the wait in line near the escalators, and then no one was 6 feet apart, no one. And then we got to walk over. So I just realized right now that we have to walk back to the parking structure. That's gonna be fun.
What is Grumpy's favorite fruit?
Oh.
Sour grapes?
For those of you that didn't get that, what is Grumpy's favorite fruit? Sour grapes. Ba-dum-tsh. I walked 10 miles, 19,000 steps. It's 8:45, and I'm finally leaving. Park closed at 7, by the way, so we stayed well past we were supposed to.